Okay, now our next speaker is Dr. Srikant Kallurkar, and I invite Professor Ram Vilas from South Africa to introduce the second speaker, Professor Ram Vilas.
Namaste and thank you, Professor Ravi ji. It is indeed a privilege to introduce to you Dr. Srikant Kallurkar. Srikant ji is a member of the Institute for Studies in Vedic Sciences, that is at Shivpuri, Akkalkot in Maharashtra, and he's principal of Atharva College of Engineering in Mumbai. He holds a BE Mechanical, MMS, and his doctorate is in industrial engineering. He has guided 22 PhDs from 7 universities in India. He has published over 100 research papers. He has, to his credit, over 400 citations and 40,000 readings of papers. He has worked on World Bank projects through the MHRD, which is an institute of the Government of India for development of quality technical education in India. His topic is Agnihotra for the development of an enterprising personality. And in this presentation, he speaks of Professor McClelland of Harvard University and the concept of NACH, NACH. Then he discusses a sample study where there were 400 participants in an Agnihotra-based training for business opportunities. And then he relates this program of development to the Panch or the five koshas. So thank you very much, Dr. Srikant, for being with us. And it is now my pleasure to ask you to do your presentation. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. So, as it was mentioned, I was working in the field of development of technical entrepreneurship, and I came across certain qualities for which we found that there are no existing methods. Need for achievement, that is NEC, which is recommended by Professor McClelland from Harvard University, is supposed to be the base of developing enterprising personalities all over the world. And majority of the institutions in India also follow that. But the problem is, when we offer a program, the need for achievement is at its peak. The qualities to be a successful entrepreneur are very high. But over a period of time, it goes on reducing. So there is a need to provide something as a catalyst. That's one. Another thing, the need for achievement model demands certain qualities of analytical ability. I was working with for Maharashtra Center for Entrepreneurship Development. And they had received some funds from international agencies to develop the entrepreneurship amongst the below poverty line people. Yesterday there was a question, I saw it on the YouTube also, that someone asked, what's the use of all these discussions for a common man? So my work is basically for a common man, because I started with the people who are from below poverty line, like hawkers and small shopkeepers from the villages and all these things. And the organizers found in that program that probably the existing models do not work. So the organizer, his name happened to be Mr. Salunke, Prashant Salunke, Prakash Salunke, late Prakash Salunke, he's no more there. So he asked me, sir, offer something different. Because the audience is not able to accept the existing model of interventional development? Can we create something different? So I thought that why not try with Agnihotra?
Yeah, yeah.
My lecture was on day two. And I delivered a session which is depicted in the PowerPoint that I had shared. That was the base of it. But
Namaste.
In addition to that, at the end of the day, exactly at the time of sunset, I requested the people to perform Agnihotra. The whole idea was, the people took it this way that bahut kuch padh liya hai, we have learned so many things, now let's do some rituals, let's do some puja. So with that intention they started. In fact, the beauty of this program was, there was one Muslim lady and lot of complaining attitude. She was complaining to me that these people asked me to get up at 6 o'clock and I had to take bath with cold water. I'm not feeling well because of that. These people do not provide the hot water, that kind of things. And on the last day, I received a call from Mr. Prakash Sarungke. And he said to me, "Sir, what have you done?" I thought probably something has gone wrong and everyone is complaining. What thing has been given to us? So I said, "Give me 10 minutes, I will reach to the destination." He said, "No, sir, I've never seen such a drastic change in the attitude of the people in any kind of training program of entrepreneurship development that we are doing it for the years together. There is something unique which has happened with this group, and everyone is charged with some new concepts, new ideas. Everyone is charged." And then I understand that that's the beauty of Agnihotra. And when I talked to the same Muslim lady, she said, "Now there is no problem. I'm able to comfortably get up, take bath with cold waters. I'm not having any problem. And whatever this new thing you have given, we are able to come up with that." Now this is an history about that. And when I tried to collect a data of about 150 people on a pre-coded questionnaire, for the people who are following Agnihotra, practicing Agnihotra since last minimum 3 years, because there is a concept, 3 years survival is success. If you do something for 3 years, it's quite likely that you will continue to do it for longer span of time. Or in field of entrepreneurship development, we say, we call it as a 1,000-day theory. If you are able to carry with your business for 3 years, your business will not be closed down. Maybe that you will shift from one unit to another. That's a different story. So this 3 years practicing something has a base. So we collected the data on 31 pre-coded questions on a 5-point Likert scale from the people who are performing Agnihotra and they are connected with Shivpuri. The data so collected was analyzed with the help of statistical package for social sciences and applied factor analysis. Factor analysis is one of the advanced statistical techniques which can combine the views and give us some ratings on a XY scale by bringing the variables together, and depending on the cluster of the variables, we can try to analyze what the people feel. So we wanted to know that if someone is performing Agnihotra for minimum 3 years, he must be getting something, some benefit out of it, without which why a person should perform Agnihotra? Whoever has told him, maybe he'll practice for a month or 2-3 months and then say, "Kuch nahi ho raha hai, toh let's forget it. If nothing is happening, let's forget it." If he might not be able to tell that exactly what is happening to that person. But unless directly or indirectly the person is getting some benefit, he or she will not continue to perform. And we, when I did this analysis, I found five main aspects as a result of performing Agnihotra for the people in general, not a part of this program. One is ability to practice Karma Yoga. If I say it in Hindi, Karma Yoga anurup acharan karne ki kshamata mein vruddhi. Here in Agnihotra, you are doing something as a duty consciousness. Yesterday also there was some discussions that there are large number of yajnas and few yajnas are by taking into account some results in mind, like Putra Kameshti Yajna. You want son. But then Agnihotra is something which you perform as an ordained duty by Vedas. And because of that, the duty consciousness gets enhanced, result consciousness gets reduced, and as a result, ability to practice Karma Yoga happens. Another is spiritual gain. Whatever you are doing on spiritual front, people found that Agnihotra acts as a catalyst. One very important aspect was seen as peace and prosperity. You get mental peace because, as Colonel Sir said yesterday, Sayam Sayam Grahapatir Nogni Pratap Pratap Somanasya Data. Pratap Pratap Grahapatir Nogni Sayam Sayam Somanasya Data. This Somanasya Data provides you peace of mind. But at the same time, because you are able to concentrate more on duty consciousness, whatever job you do, you excel in that, and because of that, there is automatically a prosperity. And one very important aspect which I found in case of Agnihotra, results which happened to be there in the multiple studies also, that is grace. Somewhere you feel that I am getting connected with the superpower. And because of that, the grace is there. So these are certain basic things. Keeping this in mind, I practice that in this particular program. Sir, even if I don't get the PowerPoints, I will be able to speak without that. Won't be a problem, sir.
No, I can have your I can display your PowerPoint.
Please, sir, please then. Because I'm sorry, my office had done the arrangement, but in the meantime, I came home. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
For PowerPoint, yeah. Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we can go to the next.
Just a minute. Just a minute.
Yeah.
I have in it.
Okay.
No.
Okay, no problem. So as sir had mentioned during my introduction, we ask the people to perform Agnihotra at the end of the program. Yeah, these are the acknowledgements because this research has been funded by All India Council of Technical Education, Government of India, under its R&D scheme. So, in principle, this has become a sponsored research by Government of India.
So, you let me know, I should go
right, to sir. The next slide. Next one, yeah. And I was supported by the Institute for Studies in Vedic Sciences and supported by MCED. Now, basically, this work provides an agenda of thinking. So, whenever you are taking any major decision in life, many of my students who have come back after 30 years. Last month, I met one of my students who is passed out of 1996. He owns 5 factories. He was my student of entrepreneurship development. And today, he is starting his 6th factory under funding of 400 CR from Government of Maharashtra and going to manufacture e-bike in Maharashtra. The beauty of this bike is the one which is costing around 1.25 lakhs in the market will be available for about 70 to 80,000. We are working on that. The whole idea is that, but he feels like coming back because we have been able to provide the agenda of thinking, which is useful at any stage of life. Why I gave this example? Because a 1996 pass out student in 2021 also feels like going back to the professor and discussing about the agenda of thinking before he launches his new e-bike in the market. I mean, that's the beauty of this program. So this program recommends SWOT analysis. Okay, we have gone to SWOT analysis, and there are methods to overcome the threats that has been discussed. Okay, sir, you can. Yeah, I think we can. We are going too fast. Yeah, we can come back. Right. Okay, you can stop anywhere. Yes, please. The whole idea is that whatever we do, problems are always there. But if I'm passionate about it, the problem is seen as a challenge. Otherwise, it's seen as an obstacle. So we used to tell them, do something about which you are passionate. The whole idea is, before you offer a fivefold path and panchakosh sadhana to the candidates, let them know that this has something to do with my business. Next, sir. Next form. Yeah. Yeah. So the whole idea is that you can select a business opportunity that suits to your personality, which makes you happy, and then there is a need to fine tune. That is developing the personality of self to suit to the needs of demands of the profession. Because different types of demands, professions or different types of business enterprises demand different types of lifestyle on the part of the entrepreneur himself. So here we are trying to fine tune that with the help of Panchakosh Sadhana. That is, personality is developed, is comprising of, you say, I at the bottom, at the middle of it, which is nothing but ego, which is responsible for making us to do something. But this I on its own can't do anything. It needs a medium, and this medium is the five sheets. Annamay Kosh, Pranamay Kosh, Manomay Kosh, Vijnanamay Kosh, and Anandamay Kosh. Or it can be said as food sheath, air sheath, and all that. Now, development of these five koshas is nothing but the development of personalities. And this development of personalities, it is reference to the business that I have selected. And for that, we used Panchasadhan Marga, Yajna Dhan Tapa Karma Swadhyaya as the medium. So they were exposed to Agnihotra as a part of this. We can go to the next. They were exposed to Agnihotra as a part of this. They were also told that any business needs a value addition, and the value can be said as function divided by cost. The whole idea is, how do you add value to whatever you are doing? So either you improve upon the functional ability or reduce on the cost part of it. Next, sir, because I will not go into the depth of it, because we are talking about Agnihotra and not entrepreneurship development. Next, sir, because we will not discuss about, yeah.
Next.
Now, I mean, we have given some example of a pen, and every use of a pen can create a business opportunity. So even a tertiary function of any product can also give us a business opportunity. Next, sir. Now, okay, these are actually 9 points we are able to see. And the whole idea is that you connect the 9 points without lifting the writing instruments. And if you go to the next, we'll find that basically the solution is outside the rectangle that we normally see. And that's a beauty of out-of-box thinking. And to be able to have out-of-box thinking, there is a need to understand the mechanism of mind, which has been very nicely explained by Dr. Edward De Bono in his books on lateral thinking. Though a medical doctor, he has written about 60 books on creativity. And his systems of lateral thinking are being practiced in most of the Fortune 500 companies also. So, there are perceptions and patterns of perceptions which are very strong in us, we need to change that. And to change that, we need to take a creative pause. Next, sir. So that is, what is creative pause? Dr. Edward De Bono recommends stop thinking for 20 seconds to 2 minutes. And there he mentions in his books, in his findings, that to reach to 2 minutes, you need to have a highly disciplined lifestyle. I practice this in my many of my programs with my candidates. And I found that reaching up to 10 to 12 seconds is very easy. I generally catch hold of someone who says, no, it's not possible to stop thinking. I said, okay, let's experiment with each other with complete faith. And I ask them to stop thinking and say, close the eyes, stop thinking, open the eyes when you feel that a thought has come. General, my observation is more than 100 examples, 10 to 12 seconds, one can achieve immediately. And with little practice, 20 seconds is possible. And with little extra disciplined way of life, as Edward De Bono says, 2 minutes is possible. And he recommends that in all the board meetings, Fortune 500 companies, they should ask the top officials to take a creative pause. Now, Vedas have given the time to take the creative pause. When the nature is tuned so that we can stop thinking, and that nature is tuned at the time of sunrise and sunset. That's why Karnal sir was mentioning Tirtha. That's the time when quickly you can see, one can practice that. We made it a practice. I was in Austria and I was traveling in the train, and a girl was sitting with me. And I was talking to her about this creative pause because she asked me something about agriculture economics questions. She was doing research in that field, and casually she asked me some questions. I said, okay, today at the time of sunset, you will take a creative pause. And 5 minutes before that, at the time of local sunset, I called her. She said, yes, I'm doing meditation. I know, I remember. And after some time, she telephoned me and said, yes, there is a good effect. When I practiced my meditation exactly at the time of sunrise and sunset, there was a good effect. There was no Agnihotra. It was the time effect. So Vedas prescribe the time to take the creative pause. Vedas also prescribe the environment in which that creative pause should be taken. And the environment is sacrificial environment. That is Yajniya environment. One of the research recommends that in sacrificial environment, the percentage of negative ions in the environment is high. The percentage of negative ions in the environment at beaches, in the gardens, is also high. That's the reason when we go to such places, we feel fresh. The same thing happens in case of sacrificial environment. So you are able to catch that time when you should take the creative pause. You are able to create an environment wherever you are. Maybe in the room, maybe outside, wherever you are able to create the environment so that there are the percentage of negative ions in the environment is more. And then it acts as a catalyst for tranquility of mind. And then it can become a base of personality development. This was the way we worked for. And this was accepted by AICT, and then they decided to give the funding for this research. Because Edward De Bono had recommended creative pause, which is globally accepted. And we said, we recommend the time and environment for that. So they accepted to give the funding so that further experimentations can be done. Next PowerPoint, sir. Yes, sir.
I think your time is going to over.
I'll finish.
Yes.
So these are 5 sheets known to everyone. So development of the 5 sheets, that is strategic eating, strategic exercises, strategic breathing. Practice deep breathing in this environment. Because breathe and mind, two sides are of the same coin. I will give you one example. When I was working with this group, I asked one lady. She was very short-tempered. And because of that, in a small village, she was losing her business. So after 2 years, in one of the follow-up meetings, I asked, madam, how is the business now? And she said, sir, you asked me to take a long breath. शी सेड इन मराठी, तुम्ही लांब हवा घ्यायला सांगितली. हिंदी में कहते आपने कहा था ना बड़ी लंबी हवा लेते जाओ, गुस्सा आया तो. मैंने वो चालू किया, बोले मैं अभी लंबी हवा लेती हूँ, मेरा गुस्सा चले जाता है, मेरा ग्राहक नहीं टूटता है, मेरा बिजनेस अच्छा चल रहा है. सो दैट इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ ऑल दिस थिंग्स. नेक्स्ट सर. सो आई थिंक वी कैन गो टू द लास्ट फोर पॉइंट्स. यस, सो दीज आर वेरियस शीट्स. नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट वी कैन गो टू बेनिफिट्स. या नेक्स्ट. या सो दीज आर स्ट्रेटेजिक ईटिंग एंड ऑल दिस थिंग्स. द पावर पॉइंट्स कैन बी शेयर्ड विद यू, दे कैन गो थ्रू दैट. एंड इफ यू परमिट आई विल कोट वन. आई एम वर्किंग ऑन वर्ल्ड बैंक प्रोजेक्ट. रिसेंटली आई विजिटेड SUNIT सूरत फॉर एन ऑडिट पर्पज एंड आई वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस टू वन ऑफ द प्रोफेसर एंड आई वॉज टोल्ड दैट he is a professor of electrical engineering around 55 60 age and he was able to control his diabetes for last 10 years and they were not knowing the reason and then I just casually asked him sir how do you control that he said somewhere I researched in the read in the research paper that 40% cooked food 60% raw food I practiced that for last 10 years and I am getting the benefit and I was so happy I told sir that person who wrote that paper is my so that works. I mean, whole idea is that these are practical benefits people have experienced out of it. Next. Okay, these are the deep breathing practices we recommend from Shivpuri. Next. 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 We'll go to the right. 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 Just one before. One before. Or yeah, but now the unique things which I found is increase in power of determination. Whatever you want to do, you need to have a power of determination. So Agnihotra is useful in power of determination. Colonel Deshpande was talking about alcohol de-addiction yesterday. I did some case studies, and there also I found that because of Agnihotra, people were able to decide to be away from the vices. It is because of the increase in power of determination and increase in power of rational thinking. So in two of my studies I found that Agnihotra helps in developing these two qualities and power of commitment because you are increasing the duty consciousness as I mentioned earlier and the ability to face the negative situation and development in capacity to be a complete personality. So these are the benefits we found in work, this work, and we request everyone that because it has some direct benefits which one can follow in any walk of life. See, ultimately what I want is happiness in my life, success in my life. And in this work, I found that it helps to be a successful person in the life. So I am really thankful to you, sir, that you have given me the opportunity to share my views and working. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Professor Kallurkar, you have given a very good presentation regarding how the personality can be modeled on the basis of Agnihotra and all these activities. In fact, if you are doing Agnihotra at sunrise and sunset time, exactly these times, it brings discipline to your life. If you can stick to these two times, so that discipline in your life is going to overhaul your life. Everything will change. The discipline is there in the life, and this cannot be done without discipline. It's very hard
exactly,
to do.
Exactly,
if
sir.
You are doing exactly
according. You are exactly pinpointed the point, sir. Yeah. Things exactly, very true.
That's the main thing. So right, sir. It makes you a disciplined. Just like exactly. Soldier in army, the
yes, sir.
Army soldiers are disciplined,
Genesis.
So they can sure. do anything. Our Colonel Deshpande is also a brave soldier, and he is just chasing everything, just like an yes. army man, and he is propagating yes. Agnihotra in that very spirit. And so
very
I
true.
Think if you do Agnihotra exactly at sunrise and sunset, so you are observing a great discipline in your life, and it is
very
a great
true.
Tapaha. It is a great tapaha.
Very true, sir.
So I thank you a lot, Professor Kallurkar.